Hello there. Just a brief video. Not for anything in particular, for any real reason, you know? I just wanted to do a video and record something. A lot of this is going to be for my daughter, because she likes watching me play games. So I've decided to record some Gungeon for her. But I'm also going to upload this to my YouTube channel. So hello, this is probably how you're watching it. And just to showcase one of the games I like for no particular reason other than I like to play it. So for those, well, you're about to learn what kind of game Gungeon is. It's pretty simple. Up, down, left, right. Right click makes you dodge roll. And I'm not going to explain what kind of game it is. I'm just going to kind of play it and show you as I go. So basically, you're exploring in the dungeon. You plan it. You get to through level 5. You're looking for, I can't remember, something or other. Oh no, I've already taken a hit. Not a good start. You're looking for a gun that can wind back time or something like that. You know what? I don't really care about the story. The fun thing is about it, a giant bullet crashed to Earth and like all you're doing is fighting other bullets. So you get all kinds of variations on that and that's really fun. There's not really a deep and meaningful story to this, but it's just a fun little game. You get lots of different guns as you go, and a whole variety of enemies. These are the ghost bullet ones. They're particularly annoying, because you think you got them, and then actually no, because they just disappear. So this is the basic gun. I'm playing as the hunter at the moment. She has two guns. She has that, and she has a crossbow. But most of the time, I just use the basic pistol, because it's fast. Just did that to show you guys how it works. But yeah, there's not really much to say about that. You get better guns as you go. As you can see, there are some for sale now. I can't afford any of these, but ideally you want to try and get them from chests. This is a shop. You get it once on every level. You buy keys to open chests. You buy shields, health if you need it. I recovered my health. I don't even know when I did that. The trick is to just keep moving. If you sit still, you die. Got some ammo there, which is unfortunately useless for me right now because, oopsie. Sorcerers. See, what I like about this game is there's a lot of different enemies. There's a great deal of different enemies and that makes it fun. You never know quite what you're going to get. Some of the enemies are shocking to play against. Let's put it that way. Nearly swore, trying not to swear. Okay, so there's a key. Let's see what we got. Let's see what we got from this chest. Give the dog a pat. Rocket-powered bullets. Faster bullets. Okay, I would have settled for a gun, but that's fine. We'll go with that for now. The ammo's gone. That was stolen by a rat. I'll go into that later. Or maybe not. See, you can see the speed difference, but it's not really that great, this ability. Oh, there's another key, though, so that's cool. You can teleport wherever these green circles are, you can teleport to. So that does stop you wasting too much time. That guy's just got a fancy hat. Oh wow, there's that stuff. We'll just leave that for later. The health will stay around. The rat will come back and steal the ammo. We don't care about that. Really, so I'm just going to dodge this guy. These guys just, they got a big AoE, but you know, as long as you just keep moving, keep dodging, it's all good. Go. We're looking for the boss chamber, which isn't here yet. The little flying bullet things blow themselves up and just throw themselves at you, which is kind of disappointing. Ah, we got another gun. All right, the regular shotgun. Okay, that's not great, but it's not bad. It just is. So the downside of this game, it is very RNG what kind of guns you get. I've got so many keys, Jesus. And that really makes a difference to how well you do, unfortunately. Because if you get shit guns, you are really going to be up against them. Okay, where's this boss going to be? He's pretty going to be down here. There's not really anything else he can be. There we go. Alright, we've explored the rest of the dungeon. We have. And let's get the shotgun. There's three enemies you can end up facing in this level, in level one. The Bullet King, the Gatling Gull is the Gatling Gull. Gatling Gull's not ideal to be facing. He is pretty... he's not my least favorite. He's probably my second... he's probably the second toughest. I always find the Bullet Twins to be tougher than him. See there, I've taken a hit already. It sucks. Three hits. He sprays a lot of bullets at you. Got him. Unfortunately, I took three hits. So, if you do it with no hits, you get a prize. But unfortunately, I didn't do that. Sucks to be me. But once these mobbing birds disappear, we'll actually see what the reward was for beating him. We've got a sweet magic sweet, free stat. I don't know what that does. There's so many things. Yeah. Okay. Cool. Improves health, movement speed, and damage. Well, okay. That's nice, I guess. Oh, see, it's giving you an extra heart there. Movement speed's a bit faster. So it turns out that was pretty useful. Right, we're going to jump back here and reclaim this heart. And then we'll move on to the next level. There we go. Let's see if the shopkeeper has anything I want. We've also got an old bullet here. He'll sell you things too. He thinks you're a bullet. Bless him. We can abuse his senility to get stuff, and you can't say fairer than that. Actually, you can. You don't abuse the senility of people. That's bad. I'm just gonna carry on using the gun now, the shotgun now, because in level 2 it gets a lot harder. Look at that reload time. It's a lot slower. That was, I can't remember what they're called. Anyway, this guy, when he dies, he breaks up into lots of smaller ones, and they will eventually blow up and attack you. Oh god, there's another one. Christ, how many? See, and with these ones, it's just, you may as well just hide behind a wall, wait for them to blow up and die, rather than waste your bullets on them. This is one of the enemies I really hate. Fortunately, this is a decent gun. Ah! Oh, shit. See, as you can see, like, I'm not describing the enemies. I don't know half of their names. I'm just trying to kill them as fast as I can, you know? Sometimes you get things like this. So you get chambers like this, and you can spend a key to unlock it. Normally I wouldn't do it for just a chest, but this chest wasn't locked, so that was turned out to be worth it. Okay, this gun is kind of low quality. It's not super good. As you can see, it just fires loads of post and then mailboxes, and there's a lot of gimmicky guns. Not all of them are particularly nice, but it only cost me one key to get that. Ah, shit, that was careless. I sat still for too long. Really, you shouldn't take damage from those guys. The most basic troops. Let's try this chest. What's this one giving us? Full metal jacket. Automated defenses. Let's check that one out. Automatically triggers available ranks when in danger. Oof. Not sure I like that. Really. It's like... maybe I don't want to waste my ranks, but I guess if you've got no choice but to get hit. Okay, this is a sinister altar. We definitely don't want to mess with that. See these over here? Look at those innocuous tiles. Spikes. Shotgun versus shotgun, as nature intended. The thing about the shotgun is the closer in you are, the more damage it does to your enemy. Oh, hello. There we go. And always reload before you go into the next room. Oh, there's another chest, but I'm out of keys right now. There's an altar, which requires a thing that I don't have. So let's keep exploring. See, it's a fun game. It doesn't cost very much, and it's just, wow, these guys are so annoying! Ah, my god! How I avoided getting hit by that guy, I don't know. Although maybe I did get hit. Alright, here's a shopkeeper. What has he got for me? He does have a key. Let's spend 30 on that key. Prime Primer. I think maybe you're supposed to use that somehow. Maybe on the altar. I don't know. See, there's a lot of mysteries and secrets to this game that I haven't bothered to unlock. Aha! The AK-47. Classic gun. I'm gonna... Ooh. Regular old guns. Okay. I'm gonna use that, I think, for the boss. Just to show you guys what it does. Ah, see? That's the blank trigger, because I just stood still. I stood still, so it used the blank to stop me getting hurt. And the good thing about using the dog is the dog will occasionally find you stuff. So you've got to pet the dog. You've got to pet the dog. It's kind of, it's the law. You know, I don't make the rules. I mean, I actually do. Ooh, spike traps. And I'm just going to wait here a minute. For that, yep. Oh, it only killed one. That makes me sad. It's always fun just to let the spike traps kill the enemy for you. Saves time. Yay. You can only dodge roll across those. There are some... things like that can make you fly. Little jetpack it's called, that can make you fly. Alright, let's see. Let's go for the AK-47 for this boss. Once again, there are three different kinds of boss you can face. And this one's the Medusa, which I don't particularly like. Don't look directly at her when she's doing the stone thing. I've got to get out of here because I got back to the corner and it's not good to be back to the corner. Don't look at her. Got her. No damage taken, but it did cost me all my blanks. See, the AK-47. Oh, here's a fun thing you can do. I'm going to switch back to the shotgun, because the AK-47, you got sprays the bullets away too fast. I'm going to save that for later. Gum Knight Greaves. Armor every floor. Like, I don't know what this does either. Let's have a look. Collecting all the passive items. No active items. Greaves is the Aimless Knight Cormorant. The Aimless Knight approached the Gungeon as a challenge, born more out of curiosity than regret. Despite his skill, this rendered his failure inevitable. So in the lore, you've got to be doing this because you want to change something terrible in your past. That's why you're going for the gun at the end of the game. Oh, here's the next level. This thing gives you a half a heart of health, but you don't need it. And that button there saves your progress. So I'm going to try the next level. If I can beat the next boss, I'll stop there. If I die, I'll stop there as well. You know. Black Powder Mine, level 3. Switching to the shotgun, we're going to hope to get some ammo here. And also some better guns. That guy is quite tough. He just fires a lot of bullets at you. I don't know what this arrow means. Oh god, it's this girl. Let's see, I think I got the perfect match for you. I don't think I want to pay for that. Got ice in your veins or something? Yeah, she's going to spit out something, but it costs... She's going to give you something, you may or may not like it, and it costs 57 bullets. And I don't have that kind of money. Okay, we're fine for the moment. Now, we are running low on ammo for this shotgun. We really are. Don't have a key right now, so I can't open that either. And this is a dead end. There's something spooky down here if you ride the rails, but who cares, you know. Like, over there, there's a secret. I could get it if I had the jetpack, but I don't have the jetpack. There's theoretically a way to do it just by riding the carts, but you know what, who cares. I'm not going to bother. Alright, let's go. The annoying thing about this sometimes is the dungeons are automatically generated, so you never fight the same dungeon twice. But sometimes you end up with a lot of rooms in a row without a teleport pad. Whoa, okay. I think he's immortal until I kill a thing making him immortal. There we go. Told you this gun wasn't super good. But it did get me a key out of it, so that's something. Yeah, my ammo is on a regular shotgun is running very, very low, so I'd really like to find a shop. Pretty soon. Alright, I've got a chest over there that I can try and open, but I'm going to hold on to this key for the moment and see if I get a better one later. That guy's some kind of shield. Just die, please. Oh god, no, not this again. Got him. Cool. As you can see, the enemies get more arsehole-y as the level progresses. As the levels progress. I'll use the AK-47, I think. Little room feature that you can use. That's pretty cool. See, as you can see though, that used a lot of bullets just to do that. Like, lost 80 bullets in that room. Alright, so just another key and table tech site flip multiply. You can flip tables, which is a thing, and use them as cover, but there's not a lot of tables in this level, so it's pretty useless, I think. Okay, what we want to do is get ammo for the regular shotgun. They are. Guns partly refilled. So that's... If you get a green one, it refills all your guns, I think. But no, no, it refills one gun. The brown one partly refills all your guns. So I've got some more ammo for the AK, so I'll keep using that. Save the shotgun for the boss, I think. Go, guns partly refilled again. Nice. So two ammos in a row, pretty useful. And here is the boss guy. Can get heart locket for extra health. That's gonna clean me out of excuse me. You know what, I'm gonna grab it. It's gonna clean me out of bullets pretty much, but that's fine because I do have two keys. Okay, see, bullet flipping, amazing. Absolute bullet flipping boss. Just wait for this guy to come out. Yeah, he has a nice little gimmick. And I'll just shoot you. Just shoot you in the face. So yeah, good job though. Good job, bro. You got shot in the face and for what? There's the boss. Alright, let's go check this other room. Usually there's a chest or something at the end of it. Oh god. This is a crowded room. That was a busy room. I'm amazed I didn't take any hits. Is there something in here? No. Not every room has stuff in it. Just to mess with you. Yeah, you want to kill that guy really quickly. He has some nasty abilities. So you really want to kill them fast. And that just takes me back to the beginning, so we don't want to go that way yet. What is this guy? He's kind of annoying. Ugh, can't get to him because all the flames are right there. That's kind of annoying. Come on, Bouncy McGee, get over here. There we go. Got him. Took forever, but we got him. And the AK is almost out of bullets, so I'm just gonna... Oh, hello. This is what we want to save stuff for. A trident. Under the sea. We might run with trident for the boss, because this trident is immaculately crafted, and powerful runes etched into its length allow it to channel mighty bullet magics. Wow. Sometimes when the gungeon shifts, entire realms and regions are submerged. See, every gun has a story. Some of them are better than others, but this seems like a cool gun. So I am going to stick with that. All right, let's go. We've got the boss. We've explored everything else. Have I opened all the chests that are available to me? I think I have. All right, we'll jump to the shop quickly. See, I don't have the money for anything else now, but it's fine because I've got 5 health. That's kind of useless now. Let's go... Trident for the boss. There's a lot of bosses, level 3 bosses I don't particularly like. There's one that's a tank that's pretty cool. The other bosses I'm not a huge fan of. There's one called the Cannon Balrog or something. Okay, it's the tank. This is fine. This gun isn't particularly powerful. Ah, I took a hit. It's unfortunate. Can't see him right now. Oh, he's right there. That's unfortunate. I'd like you to get lost a little bit. Just taking so much damage right now. Yeah, I might switch up my weapons a bit now. Oh, it's empty. That was a bad choice. No, let's just stick with what I know. Where is he? I can't see him. I actually see the enemy, so that's a bit of a problem. Getting mullered a bit. See, this gun seemed cool, but it's not actually that strong. I'm getting knocked about a bit by this boss right now. But we finally got him in the end. God. Took a lot. That gun is not strong. It cost me 178 shots to get it. So that's not the best gun in the world to use against this guy. Alright. Whew. But yeah, we got Mimic Tooth Necklace. Chomp. Another passive item. Unlocks all chests. Oh, that's cool. A necklace made from the tooth of a mimic. Feels lucky. Okay. Alright then. What can you say? That's kind of useful, I guess. Okay, so there's the gateway to the next level. That's what we fun thing to do is just go back and collect any hearts that you missed along the way, because I do need to replenish my heart stock now. Get my health back up a little bit. See, there's another one left there. If you just leave them, they stick around, and you can go and collect them afterwards. And they are going to come in handy. Hit trap, see? Oh, and there's another one there. See, I'm going to be back up to health pretty soon. Where is it? There it is. Okay. And let's see if this guy has any hearts available. He does. Shall I buy it? No, I don't have enough money. Super close, but no. And I think that's a good point to stop. So that's a long video, but I hope it's been fun for you guys. I will save and quit. Yeah, this is also mainly, as I say, for my daughter to watch. But I hope you guys have enjoyed watching this game as well. I'm going to be uploading lots of different content to my YouTube channel, so please hit that subscribe button if you're not subscribed already. And yeah, I'll be uploading Immortal content, Rivals content, hopefully, all sorts of things. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the next video.